In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to place yourself into a Star Wars-style environment using Camtrack AR, Blender, and HitFilm. This clip of Tom was filmed using an iPad and Camtrack AR, which you can find for free on the iOS App Store. This way, our footage is motion tracked as we film it, so we don't have to do that part in post-production. Now, when it comes to building the environment, I personally like to use Unreal Engine, but we know a lot of you use Blender as well, so we're going to show you how that process might differ. If you're new to Blender, be sure to check out our Blender to HitFilm masterclass. For this scene, we're going to use some free 3D models from Video Copilot, and the Mouse Droid model is free from Sketchfab.com. Links to download these 3D models are in the description. Import the Camtrack AR data into Blender using the included Python file, and set your video footage as the camera's background images so that you can see it. Then import the Corridor, Floor, and Blast Door 3D models. For the Blast Doors, make sure to check Split by Group so that each door comes in as a separate object, allowing them to be animated. Parent all the corridor pieces to one object and scale it to be the right size. Then place the corridor so that it looks good when it's viewed through the camera. Next, we can import the mouse droid. To animate it moving around, create a new Bezier curve. Go to Top View, enable the wireframe view, and enter Edit Mode. You can start by placing the first two points, then extrude the curve multiple times to complete the path. Edit the curve to create the path you want the droid to follow. Add a follow path constraint to the main controller of the mouse droid. Now you can animate the offset value to make it drive along the curve. You probably don't have to animate the wheels turning since the detail won't be visible in the final shot. The corridor models don't come in with the textures already set up, so you'll need to edit the materials. Here's what the node setup looked like for our final project. The mouse droid didn't come with any textures, so you can create a simple noise texture in Blender. Using this texture for the roughness adds some nice detail into the model. The environment outside of the hallway is an HDRI from polyhaven.com. By setting the film to transparent, the HDRI won't be included in the render, but will still cast light and reflections into the scene. This way, we can adjust the background in HitFilm without having to re-render out of Blender. You can add an additional light set to orange to bring out more of the desert color into the scene. You can also add a bright red light to represent the lightsaber illuminating the environment. Once our render is complete, we can hop over to HitFilm to composite our two scenes together. The first step is to remove the green screen, and we have a detailed tutorial on that linked in the card on screen. When you're importing the background from Blender, make sure that the frame rate of the image sequence matches your footage. To add the distant background outside the open doorway, import the HDRI and apply a 360 viewer effect. The composite shot created by Camtrack AR includes the tracked 3D camera. So the HDRI background will match the movement of the scene without any extra work. You can also apply a lens blur effect so that it appears slightly out of focus. To blend these layers together, start with a curves effect to take some red out of the darker areas, matching the bluer color of the hallway. Then apply some light wrap effects. The light wraps are sourcing a grade layer so that the effect uses both of the background layers. The desert environment should be quite bright compared to the darker hallway, so you can brighten it up with an exposure effect. I'll also use hue and saturation effects to further match the color of the different layers. Additional details will help add flare to the composite. I'll add a blue-tinted glow to the hallway lights and add a similar glow to the exterior environment to match it and make it even brighter. A final grade layer can be used to tweak the colors and add additional lens effects like lens dirt, chromatic aberration, and film grain to tie it all together. If you'd like to learn how to create your own lightsaber effects, we have loads of tutorials on this channel covering that subject, so be sure to check those out. Remember to subscribe for more videos like this, and we'll see you all in the next tutorial.